Some of these stones weigh more than modern trucks, with individual monoliths exceeding 70 tons, all situated in the middle of a ruthless desert. In this video, we uncover the engineering secrets behind the greatest builders in history. This is the legacy of ancient Egypt. The scale is staggering, from the Temple of Hatshepsut to majestic Abu Simbel. Yet construction was only half the battle. The true challenge lay in delivery. Stones had to be hauled for tens of kilometers from quarries. Thousands of workers carved these blocks from solid rock by hand. The effort was monumental. Perhaps most remarkably, they had no modern machinery, no cranes, no trucks. Even wheels were useless here. They would simply sink into the sand. Physics provided the solution. Wooden sledges, simple designs carried smaller stones, while massive timbers reinforced the sledges for the giants. Hundreds of workers pulled in unison. But the secret to success lay right under their feet. A single person walked ahead, pouring water onto the sand. A simple act reduced friction by half, making the impossible real. Experiments show that a team of about 20 people could haul a block weighing 2 to 5 tons at a speed of less than 1 kilometer per hour. Stones from nearby quarries were usually delivered to the temple within a single workday. The stones weren't lifted, they were guided upward. Ramps of clay and sand allowed them to raise blocks weighing tens of tons level by level. The engineering started even deeper. To support such immense mass on the soft Nile soil, they dug massive pits filled with layers of compressed sand. These sand cushions acted as seismic shock absorbers, keeping the temples stable for millennia. Among their most daring feats were the obelisks, monoliths carved from a single piece of red granite. Workers used harder dolerite stones to pound the rock into shape for months. If even a hairline crack appeared, the work stopped instantly. A single mistake could turn months of labor into an abandoned monument left in the dust. We see these ruins as colorless stone, but to the Egyptians, they were alive. They used natural minerals like iron oxide, malachite, and lapis lazuli to create everlasting pigments. Mixed with plant gums or egg whites, these paints turned every temple into a vibrant, divine masterpiece. The precision remains haunting. Blocks were fitted so tightly that not even a knife blade could pass between them. No cement, no mortar. Inside, the architecture even manipulated sound, where a whisper could be heard across the entire hall. Engineering met astronomy. Twice a year in Abu Simbel, a beam of light travels 60 meters to illuminate the face of the pharaoh.